it's Suki here, and welcome to the Fashion Notebook. If you've been here for a while, yes, I got new glasses. They look so different, and I don't know how I feel about it. I got so many criticism on these glasses, probably the most criticism I got in my entire life. But I think it looks fine, I'm just gonna go with it. Haters gonna hate. Just joking, they're not haters, they're my friends. So for today's video, seeing from the title, it is another review video. No surprise to you guys, because I tend to get the most views on my review video. So I gotta be realistic here with you guys. If I get more views, I'm gonna make more of those videos, because that means you guys like it. And today, what I'm going to review is another bag, and it is the Poppin Suki mini camera bag. This is the exact one I have in the pink shade. Where should I start? Let me just start talking you through the price. This camera bag is 1,572.93 Hong Kong dollars, which I will convert it into different currencies here. And I have to be brutally honest, I don't think the bag is worth that much of a price. Like, the price does not reflect to the quality of this bag. I got it a year ago, and at that time, I didn't have a lot of choices. I think this was the only bag that Suki Waterhouse produced. Now, like, when I check on their website, there are so many type of bags. There's like big camera bags, there's carry-all, there's emerald croc camera bag, there's makeup case, there's bigger makeup case, there's metallic camera bag, there's so many things. And I can tell that her company just expanded a lot within the year, which is very good. Kudos for you, Suki. I'm like one of your biggest fans, because not only that we share the same name, just your products are just really cute and amazing. And I guess the best thing about this bag, like the color is just really cute. And one more thing is that the add-ons is extra price as well, which is sneaky of them. And it's just, why can't you just give me my tassel as well? Because this bag looks weird without a tassel. I think the tassel just makes everything really cute. And let me tell you the price of the tassel. The tassel is 201 Hong Kong dollars, which I will insert it in different currency here again. It's just way overpriced. Come on, this tassel is 201 Hong Kong dollars. How? Like, I just don't get it. It's cute. I mean, it's really cute, but it's just a really smart marketing strategy, since without this tassel, this bag just look really weird. It's just like a rectangular bag, and with this tassel, it's cute rectangular bag. I mean, you can add a lot more add-ons on this bag. It's not only the tassel. You could add straps, bestie charms, and I got the long strap, which is the one that came with the bag, but you can also choose backpack straps, you can choose fanny pack straps, you can choose scallop straps, etc. And it costs different prices. Just to clarify, I'm not shading Suki at all, but I just think that it is just a bit ridiculous how you have to purchase everything separately. Like, it doesn't come with anything except for a rectangular bag and a strap, which is the extreme basis of a bag. And if you want to add some accessories, you just have to add extra price, and it is not cheap at all. So just gotta think before that. And also, one thing about their bag is that it leaves marks. You can't really tell on camera, but there is indents. There's like dents on my bag, so you have to be super careful, because this bag is not very stiff compared to my Chanel or Gucci bag, which I have done a video on. Even though it is not that obvious, it still kind of bugs me sometimes, because I know there is just some imperfections on my bag. It just bugs me sometimes. I guess one thing that makes this bag so special is like the name section underneath. It just makes it so much more personal to you. And like, a bonus thing for me, because my name is Suki and their brand is Poppin Suki, so like, my name is just imprinted on the zipper as well. It says Poppin Suki, so it makes it extra personal for me. If I have to rate this bag, I'll give it like a 7 out of 10. Even though the quality doesn't reflect the price, it is still a very cute bag. And yes, I have to talk to you about the packaging. Oh my gosh, this bag comes with like the cutest packaging ever. I remember it came with like a big box that is like a standard cake box. If you don't see what's inside that bag, I actually thought it was a cake for my birthday, but it turns out to be this really cute bag. So it's just really, it's just this really cute baby pink box. I'll insert a picture here if I can find it. And then there's this bag, and there's also a note from Suki Waterhouse and her friend Poppy. It's like a handwritten note saying that thank you for your purchase. It's just everything really cute and thoughtful of them, so that is something, just a bonus about this bag. And the storage of this bag, the inside of this bag is just Pop and Suki. It is imprinted on the fabric. It's just that. There's no like side pockets or anything. It's just a plain cotton lined polyester bag. You don't, it's not really that spacious compared to my Gucci and my Chanel bag, but you can still fit your essentials in. Just a cute bag. And one of the thing is that the straps are also adjustable, so if you have a long torso, you can make it longer. If you have a short torso, you can make it shorter, so that is great. I hate how this, when the straps are not adjustable, and it just, you just can't make it fit to you. Like, one of the biggest downfall of my Gucci Sylvie bag is that the straps are metallic gold chains and they are not adjustable, so it comes a bit short on my body when I wear a crossbody, which looks kind of weird, but I'm slowly getting used to it, as I have already briefly talked about it in my other video dedicated to my Gucci bag. But like, one of the best thing about this is the straps are adjustable, cute color, cute gold detailing as well, personalized name, super cute packaging, 100% great. So yeah, I guess that is what I have to say about this bag. If you're thinking of buying it, I do not highly recommend you to buy it, because the price really is a bit pricey. Like, just the add-ons and like the, just bugs me a lot. Like, can't you be a bit more generous and lower the price for the add-ons and stuff, you know? Like, the bag is a bit pricey, but if you are thinking of giving your best friend or your girlfriend a birthday present, I think this is just a really cute one. If you think it's a bit pricey, you can go with the makeup bags. I assume it is less expensive. Oh, also, to put it into perspective how big this bag is, this is my phone. This is the standard iPhone 6s. Oh no, I actually forgot like what model my phone is. I think it is 6s, because like 6s, 5s, 7, they all look so similar. The size comparison, and I can comfortably fit my phone in, fit my like wallet in, like small size wallet, card holder in, tissues in, earphones. That's around how much I can put in. I can't fit in my umbrella jackets, because obviously. So yeah. And I guess that is it for my Pop and Suki camera bag review. I hope you liked it. If you like reviews, please give it a thumbs up and just let me know down in the comment section below, because I love talking to you about what I purchased and the yays and nays about it as well, because I think it is really helpful for future customers. I personally like to watch YouTube videos before I splurge on an item like a Gucci bag or anything. I just want to make sure it is good quality, genuine, worth my price. So all of my opinions are genuine here, no sponsorship, no anything, because I'm a small YouTuber, so I don't get sponsored in anything. So I guess that is the perks of watching smaller YouTubers. So yeah, I guess that is it, and I'll see you guys next week with another new video, probably an outfit video. Okay, bye! If you... no further... how do you say it? It's not that... Even though it is not that impurities, no, not impurities, there is just some imperfections.